And in essence, all they have when the sunlight is reflected on the solar panel, electrons start to move, which create the electricity, which then goes to the grid.
Alright, the variables, or the independent variable is the solar panel and the backpack. A dependent variable is the amount of energy that the solar panel will collect from the sun, so it can charge the phone or other device. And the control variable would be the daily routine of the user and the sun.
So the do-it-yourself solar backpack is a great asset for anybody who's on a college campus like us. Since we're constantly moving around, moving different buildings, we constantly get direct sunlight, so it would be great to have a solar panel on you, and it is, you don't have to go to an outlet and plug it in somewhere. And it's also even good for someone who's lost in the desert.
Alright, so the materials we had, as you can see, is the backpack, the solar panel, which is 2 watts, 6 volts, or 350 milliamperes, electrical tape, wire cutters, regulated batteries. We actually use 6 to charge the electric energy. USB male and female ports, which would be the chargers. Charge controller, which would be a little And we put the prices on them, so that you can see, like, what you could buy online or at the store. And it's all, it's about a third of the usual cost of the normal backpack. So therefore, you could make it yourself and keep it cheap.
We'll go over the circuit. We have the solar panel connected to charge controller. We have our 2 battery trays, which is here, on the front, you can see it, which I take the 6, and we have that doing little modifications. This is a 4 tray, the way. That also goes with the charge controller, which then has a charge controller to the control charger.
So what we're trying to do is trying to make it easy for everybody to use. And so making it easier to use, when you actually have the backpack, people who are not too fond of making the backpack itself, we're going to have a little kit, and the kit's going to have instructions and every single part that you'll need, excluding the backpack, obviously. So that's it for that. And we're trying to make it cheap to where it's affordable for everybody, so it's a good cost for everybody.
We were inspired by our Go Baby Go.
We were in Mr. Carthage's class. Is up there, and he took us on a field trip to his lab, where electrical engineer students and a whole other organizations got together and helped disabled kids. Mrs. Morgan actually elaborated us on morning meeting, and essence of trying to help those who can't afford a wheelchair or a place where kids can sit.
So for the problems that we had, it was about the materials within the time frame that we had. So we needed certain materials that also ties in with Apple's group member Cameron. The phone we were intending to use was the iPhone 5S to charge it, and it takes 8.5 hours to actually charge the iPhone. So since he was gone, we weren't actually able to get the iPhone. And that ties in with the lack of data because we weren't able to actually finish our experiment. And when it comes to configuring issues, we started out using the 5S and we had to switch it to the 6S Plus because obviously we weren't able to get the phone. And some things with configuring is that we started off with a certain amount of batteries, and the batteries that we had would end up messing up somehow, or we didn't have enough. And also, when we were actually connecting it, we needed, there were 4 cables and we had to have 5 cables within the battery, within the iPhone charger to actually configure that device that we had.
And another thing we had trouble with is, like, with the materials coming late, we didn't get into, like, earlier this week, so by the time we were actually ready to collect data, it started to rain, so we couldn't get the sunlight. And for acknowledgments, I want to thank Dr. Tellum, he's not here right now, Mr. Green, Ms. Morgan, Ms. Santiago, the College of Engineering for letting us use their facility, and the TCs for our